Hello, mammals! In our last episode, we took a look into the No Man's Sky introductory tutorial. We began the never-ending grind for resources, learned to repair our equipment, ransacked the homes of some innocent aliens, then finally found and repaired our first starship. But the journey has only just begun. With our sense of adventure at its peak, and our taste for burglary not even close to satiated, we're now able to zip around our local star system and explore the nearby planets. Our primary goals in the next trek of our adventure will be to check out what sort of beautiful worlds our first star system holds for us, find a suitable site for our very first base, pilfer money and resources from aliens right in their dumb faces, and ultimately install our warp drive so that we can extend our reign of terror to countless worlds. So let's get to it and experience the experience. When we last left off, we were diving nose first into a neighboring planet. Let's see what awaits us. Once you make it to the general area, you'll hop out and use your fancy binoculars to pinpoint the exact location of the beacon. If you land in a good spot, you'll have a nice leisurely stroll across light level terrain. Or you could land where I did. Since we decided to turn our 2-minute walk into an intense climb up almost vertical cliffs, we didn't bring nearly enough oxygen for our life support, so if you need to take a quick detour to grab some plant air, this would probably be the time for that. Technology recharge. Once you make it to the beacon site, don't get distracted by the nightmare fuel fauna that is wandering about, like this cow with pus-filled pustules all over its hips. Or this dinosaur with this completely normal foot. And this amalgamation that for as long as I sat around and stared at it, could not think of words to describe. After partying all night with the wildlife, go ahead and access the broken beacon that we originally came for to extract plans required to build our first base. The all-important base computer, and a terrain manipulator. Now to build it, we need a very important resource that you will almost never have enough of. Chromatic metal. We get this by grinding other metals with science. Scan around for some copper, and head on over. Once there, you can simulate the actual experience of being a real-life space miner using your newly crafted terrain manipulator to suck the copper right out of the ground, directly into your inventory. Refine that dirty ore into beautiful chromatic metal using your portable refiner. And we're ready to build our first base computer and stake claim on this... well, not here. Let's explore our system and see if we can find a prettier planet to call home. Lucky for us, our starting solar system is just filled with prime base building locations. We have the swampy green mushroom land, the desolate post-apocalyptic countryside of New Mexico, and an ugly purple fungus world. Oh well, however will we decide? Fortunately, the ugly purple fungus world has a nice training facility that we can build next to for easy access to weak and easily intimidated aliens that we can push around for knowledge and resources, and a training terminal. So let's plop down our base computer and lay claim to our very first disturbingly moist plot of land.
Computer online.
Interacting with the base computer will give us some basic blueprints that we could use to build a simple home to act as our first base of operations. So, what sort of base shall we build? In No Man's Sky, you are limited only by your imagination. Explorers have built everything from grand, sprawling cities to luxurious command centers to low-orbit space stations. Now, let's take a look at our first Fortress of Solitude. Okay, limited by imagination and building parts, you aren't given too much to work with in the beginning. But shortly, you will have access to a construction research unit to unlock a few more blueprints. And if you have the selection of planets in your system that we have here, you'll most likely want to save your materials for a real base build once you've found a planet that doesn't smell like cheesy feet. So, how do we go beyond our lonely little solar system? Well, the game isn't quite finished equipping us with all of our tools. We still have the hyperdrive to construct. But first, the game wants to introduce us to the space station. Almost every star system with life has an active space station run by the system's local alien species. In some hostile systems, they have even been taken over by a rowdy band of pirates. While each has its own semi-unique look on the outside, there seems to be a monopoly on the space station interior design market in the No Man's Sky universe, as all the interiors of both normal stations and pirate stations each have their own same basic layout. However, the feng shui is different, and the stupid aliens will move their little treasures around in a weak attempt to protect their meager life savings from our greedy mitts. But stay vigilant and take whatever you want, without ever needing to face the consequences of your actions. There are a few important things to do while visiting any space station. You have access to an appearance-changing station, where you can routinely change your look to keep anyone who might recognize you off your scent. Chatting with the locals will also unlock more and more of their language, so you can slowly understand why they are always screaming and scrambling to hide their precious family heirlooms whenever they see your ship enter the hangar. This is also one of the few places where you can add an inventory or equipment slot to your exosuit. You can and should do this once at each space station, and it's completely free, keeping all those stolen units safely in your bank account. After ensuring generations of alien families remain in a state of perpetual poverty, it's time to leave this desolate system to find one with a planet worthy of calling home. Fly or use the station's teleporter to return to your swamp base. Interacting with your base computer will unlock the location of the hyperdrive blueprints, located in a crashed capital ship. After obtaining the plans, we can dig around the wreckage and obtain what is sometimes a few nice pieces of rare materials or equipment, but is most likely going to be garbage. After we install our new hyperdrive, our dream to fly to the stars is quickly shattered by the realization that we not only need fuel, but since gas stations don't exist, we have to make it ourselves. So it's one last hop over to an abandoned and very slimy outpost where we're given the required plans to make our hyperdrive fuel. If you're like me, you notice these plump and juicy eggs and thought to yourself, I really want to shoot these with my mining laser. Well, if you must, just know that these eggs are a trap, and if you want an omelet, you're going to have to fight for it. And now we can finally refuel our hyperdrive and set sail through the galaxy. Each one of these stars is its own star system. Most have one of three alien species managing its own of several types of economies, all with randomly grown planets and moons just waiting to be explored. And that is what we'll be doing in our next episode, in search of a beautiful planet to claim as our homeworld. So stay beautiful, and thanks for hanging around, mammals.